All right, today is Sunday, and it's Mo on the go with another show for you. Today we are with a beautiful musician from Kenya called Geraldine Odwar, and the song is Sweep Over Me.
Years who is, they tried all and the great I am. Elohim, the God who reigns, he is Jehovah. God of covenant, who redeemed me from destruction. He gave me hope when all was lost. He is Jehovah. Sweep over me. Sweep over me.
Holy Spirit.
You are the Lord. Jehovah Shalom, the Lord thy righteousness, the Lord who is omnipresent. You are the lily of the valley, Emmanuel, God with us. Sweep
over
me.
Sweep over us. May the Lord keep us. May the Lord protect us. May the Lord help us not to be swept away and destroyed. You know, these are the dark days when there's so much going on. And we have to keep on praying and asking God for protection so that we don't get swept away and swept away with the waters and swept away with the winds and the strong winds of destruction. Just because we don't have any self-control, or just because we don't have knowledge about who it is who is supposed to protect us in this day and age. So today, what is the story for today? It's a Sunday afternoon. I hope you guys are having a good time. The weather is pretty cloudy today. You know, it was quite difficult to get up and come out and talk to you. But you know what? It's something that I have to do. You have to be motivated to get up and remember who it is who created us. We are only here as sojourners on this land, and therefore every minute counts. And every minute talking to you, my dear subscriber, my dear friend, my dear visitor, is worth every moment. I hope you're going to enjoy today's discussion. If you went to church, that's great. You can come back and listen again. If you didn't go to church, that's okay. You can listen to this, and you can also listen to all the Word of God, the words of God, and you have to use the spirit of discernment to identify them, to identify the Word of God that is available through the internet and through other networks. Thank God for these platforms that He has provided for us to spread His positive word. Okay, so today we're going to talk about, you know, the fire of God that sweeps through us, you know, the negative spirits of this world that come sweeping through our lives, you know, wanting to destroy. Because the devil is a liar and he's an agent of destruction. And therefore we ask God to cover us, to sweep over us, okay? Because when God decides to react, He reacts in a very, very strong way, in a strong force that is able to take us all out of here, like in a sec, you know, in a second. Yeah. You know, in the Genesis, in the book of Genesis, which is the first book of the Bible, of the Holy Bible, in the book of Genesis chapter 18, Abraham was negotiating with God, and he said, God, will you sweep away the righteous together with the wicked? You know? What if there were like 50 righteous people in a city? Will you still destroy the city? Even if, you know, there are still 50 rich righteous people in it? Won't you just spare the city just for the sake of the righteous people? You'll be so surprised that God actually says, no, actually no, you know? It will give me great pleasure to destroy the whole city, including all those people who are righteous in it. Because you see, even if you're righteous, you're supposed to have an impact. You're supposed to have an influence over your city. You're supposed to move the city towards good. So if you're righteous just for yourself, that doesn't really help. You know, we're supposed to actually, our righteousness is supposed to be showing in the city and spread within the city because of who we are. We're supposed to be a light into the city. Again, in other books of the Bible, like 2 Thessalonians, okay, the Lord talks about the fact that the lawless one will be revealed. From the Lord Jesus will sweep away from the tempest of his anger and utterly overwhelmed by the awful splendor of his coming, you know. So it talks about sweeping all through the Bible, you know. It's not just about Jesus going and sweeping the market traders out of the church, you know. God's power sweeps through the earth. It sweeps through people. And you don't want to be caught up with those sweeping powers of God, you know, without some sort of cover and protection, you know. So in Habakkuk, he says, watch out, I'm bringing the Chaldeans, those cruel and impetuous people who sweep across the earth, dispossessing people of houses that are not their own. So you see those people who will go around sweeping people down and dispossessing people of houses that are not even their own, you know. God is going to release sweeping winds over those people. Who are the Chaldeans, by the way? The Chaldea was actually, I discovered that it was a country in the 9th or 10th BC that was absorbed eventually into Babylonia. The Chaldeans were known to be very intelligent people. These people, you know, had a lot of academia in them, basically. You know, they had learned a lot. They were knowledgeable. They were the people who had all the knowledge and all the academics. Call it the elite of the society in those days. But in addition to the elite, they had another side of them that was extremely, extremely evil, you know. So they had evilness. The Bible talks about the evilness that is uncomparable with other places, okay? And that area of Chaldea is today the southern part of Iraq, okay? The Semitic-speaking people, okay? In Jeremiah, it talks about the wind sweeping away the shepherds. Who are the shepherds? The shepherds are those who are supposed to be the teachers. The teachers, the people who manage us, the people who manage God's word, the people who spread God's word, the people who are leading us, leading what we call, quote unquote, the flock, the followers. So the teachers of the law are also going to be swept away, okay? And their lovers are going to go into captivity. This is Jeremiah 22, verse 22. And your lovers will go into captivity. Then you will surely be ashamed and humiliated because of all your wickedness. You know, recently we've been seeing a spate of wickedness with the so-called shepherds of the churches in Kenya and in other parts of the world, you know. You hear them speak things and utter things that you know very well are certainly not at all from Christ or at all Christian. And God talks about them. It's not like he didn't know that they exist. They actually do exist and he knows about them. Yeah, and he's coming to sweep them away because of all the iniquity. And their lovers are going to be held into captivity. You know, what it means is that they're going to be basically jailed. They're going to be captive. They're not going to be free. They're going to lack the freedom that they're given now. So those people who are teachers of the law today, you better be careful that you're not swept away, you know, and captured into captivity and humiliated because of your wickedness. You know, you have to always strive not to be wicked, but to be righteous with God. Okay, you know, the Bible tells us not to love the world or the things of this world. Okay, because if you love the things of this world, then the heart of God is not in you. We all, you know, we are tempted so much by the things of this world. We all love the things of this world. We all want to have the best in this world. But this world, as we know, we are sojourners in the world, and it's temporary, you know. So we have to remember that the love of the Father is not in the things of this world. It's in our hearts, and it's in our souls, and it's our righteousness. It's in our behavior, you know. It's in our attitude, it's in our values, it's in the way we behave and show, you know, demonstrate love in the world, you know. It's not to say that the things of this world are evil, but to love them too much means that you forget, you idolize those things. You end up idolizing those things. It says in Genesis, it also says that in the beginning, in the creation of the earth was without form and without shape, and darkness was hovering over the abyss. A mighty wind of God was sweeping over the waters. So can you imagine that? Darkness, you know, there was a, you know, the earth was without any form or shape. There was just like shapeless, completely shapeless. And you can just imagine the darkness hovering over. And you can imagine that there was this mighty wind. Can you imagine the terror in there? And then God said, let there be light. And there was light. And as soon as there's light, oh, then at least you can see. You have a little bit of control. You know, you feel a little bit safer. Because can you imagine being in the darkness with water, with wind, you know, with darkness? My goodness, you know, it's very frightening. So he said, let there be light. And then he also talked about the waters, and he brought calmness to the waters of the sea, you know. So we should be careful about these winds that sweep across, you know. He talks about, God talks about judging. I will sweep away everything from the face of the earth, declares the Lord. I will sweep away both man and beast. I will sweep away the birds of the sky and the fish in the sea and the idols that cause the wicked people to stumble. What do we idolize? We have to be so careful not to idolize anything, not to idolize anyone, you know, because then we end up stumbling. And God says he will destroy all mankind from the face of the earth. Because if you idolize anything, you idolize any situation, you idolize any opportunity. If we idolize any opportunity or anything like that, we idolize education, we idolize travel, we idolize whatever, we idolize people, you know, we are going to be swept away. You know, God is going to destroy us in one flick, you know. It doesn't take much for us to be destroyed, you know. But at the same time, there is hope as well, because God talks about that he's also the God who will sweep away our transgressions. And that is in Isaiah 43, verse 25. He says, it is I who sweeps away all your transgressions for my own sake and remembers your sin no more, okay? In Isaiah 43, 2, it says, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. So you see, Lord, as long as we are, you know, one with God, we are free and we are, you know, safe from being swept away. He says, though you go through fire, you will not be scorched, and the flame shall not set you ablaze. Okay? It just means we will have to go through these trials, temptations, and these fires, but we're not going to be set ablaze by them. Okay? So God promises the afflicted, and he says that, the water, he promises the afflicted hope of salvation, you know. He says, though you pass through fire, you will not be scorched. So, you know what, we are expected to pass through fire. We will go through fire. We will go through rough waters. We will, you know, pass through the waters and the rivers. But we're not going to be swept away with it, you know. What it means when you say being swept away is not physically being swept. Because, of course, if you jump into a river, you're definitely going to be swept away. So don't try this at home, you know. But what it means is that when you're passing through circumstances and situations that seem to be driving you in a direction that you're not aware of and in real fast, as long as you have an anchor in God, then you're okay. Then you're safe, you know. And that's actually what matters. That, you know, we should not be afraid to pass through difficulties, through trials, through fires, through temptations. Because as long as we have our grounding and our foundations in God, who is the master and, you know, the master of the universe, we are fine. We are fine. But as long as our iniquities start to take over, our coveting and our jealousy, then we are in trouble. And, you know, this is how you recognize these negative spirits. They're called unclean spirits in the Bible. Okay? You look at the book of Matthew, chapter 12, and the book of Luke. I'm all over the Bible, by the way. You know, for me, I like just to analyze the whole thing and try to make sense and, you know, of everything that's going on in the Bible. Everything that God says, because I believe all the books of the Bible are relevant. Yeah? So, we all know that we have difficulties of breaking bad habits, you know? And we are actually warned in the books of Matthew and Luke that when an unclean spirit comes out of a man, it passes through arid lands and it tries to identify a place to rest. But then it says, I'm going to go back to that house, which is actually your heart or your mind. You know, I'm going to go to that house, back that house that I left, because it's not able to find any rest, you know. So when it's not able to find any rest, it says, let me return. But when it returns, what does it find? It finds the house, your heart, has been swept clean, and your mind, there's order, and you've even garnished it, and you've decorated your home. And that means you're a new person. And so what does it do? It says, it looks like I don't have any place to reside here. Because you know those unclean spirits, they're unclean. They're coming in with dirt. So they decide to go out and bring seven other spirits. I don't know what the significance of seven is, but I'm sure there must be some significance. So that unclean spirit that is going out there in the arid land, unable to settle, decides to come back with seven other unclean spirits, and now it comes up with power. Okay? And it says, it shall go and it shall dwell there. And the final plight of man is worse than when they had their first spirit. So if you backslide, you know, if you slip back, it's very even more dangerous than when you were there the first time. Because this particular time, the devil has, the unclean spirit has learned you, has come back, checked you out, you know. And it now knows that it needs to come back with a bit more force. Because you have a bit more, what do we say? You have a little more strength this time. So this time it comes down with you, you know. So you have to be really careful to guard your spirit. We have to be very careful to guard our spirits, not to backslide. And to quickly come back, very quickly. Clean our house, put it in order. And how do we clean our houses? We clean it by praying. We clean it by asking God for forgiveness, by repenting of our sins, by changing the way we behave, by changing how, you know, we view the world. By not wanting to be lying, but not lying, not being covetous, not stealing, not being jealous, not being immoral, not being deceitful. You know, we are told in 1 Peter chapter 2, to make a clean sweep of malice and pretense and envy and hurtful talk. Let me say it again. 1 Peter 2 says, make a clean sweep of malice, pretense, envy, and hurtful talk. Talk, you know. So, even I'm guilty of this. I know I say things that can hurt people. And my goodness, you know, I really need deliverance from that. I know that. That's my small weakness. If I get angry, I can say things, you know, that can actually hurt people. But you know what? I admit that that is my weakness. And I make sure that I'm going to now ensure that I make a clean sweep of all of that and correct all of that. Okay? So, God says, the word of his mouth is iniquity and deceit. You know? You know somebody who has an unclean spirit because they have iniquity, they have sins, and they're deceitful. Okay? They have left off to be wise. They have left off wisdom and doing good. They no longer want to be wise or do good. You know? They do not listen to the voice of God anymore. They say, but my people will not hearken to my voice. So how is it that we are going to be, you know, safe? How do we keep ourselves safe and keep ourselves away from being swept away? Like my grandmother who said, do not be swept away from the things of this world. In my language, it's even, you know, stronger. You know, it's even stronger. I speak Kikuyu. And if I say it in Kikuyu, some of you will understand it. So I'm going to say it in Kikuyu for some of you so that you understand it. And you know, there's some things that are very difficult to translate into English. So I remember my grandmother saying, Motiga taho ne doshia deno. Motiga taho, morore motiga taho. Do not be, you know, do not be swept up. You know, do not be like collected. Yeah? Do not be gathered with the things of this world. Because in the end, they don't even make any sense. And apart from my grandmother who said that, my grandmother's sister who said that, there's also Steve Jobs, you know, the founder of Apple Computers, who also noticed in the end that in the end, nothing means anything, you know, without, you know, our spirituality. It means absolutely nothing. So let us not be deceived by the things of this world. They may look good. They talk about wine that shines in the glass. It talks about that in the book of Proverbs, you know? The wine that shines in the glass and looks beautiful and red. And in the end, it bites like a serpent. So we have to be careful about those things that look so attractive to us, yeah? Because we don't want to be gathered and thrown out and spat out by the things of this world, okay? So let's continue with a song with Geraldine, Sweep Over Me. I hope you guys have a lovely Sunday. I hope that I've, you know, said something that has touched you and revitalized your energy to protect yourself from unclean spirits, you know. And remember, who is in charge? Geraldine talks about El Anion. He's a king of authority, you know. He's a god of authority. He's a master god. You are highly lifted up. We have to remember to praise God because God loves praise.
The Lord God Almighty, the Most High,
the Rose of Sharon, the Lord God of hosts, King of kings, the living God. Sweep over me,
my comfort.
me, Lord. Sweep over me. You are my comforter. You are my counselor. It's been lovely chatting with you. Remember to subscribe, like, and share. This is Mo on the go. Have a great Sunday. See you all. Lovely week ahead. Toodoo.